Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's video is all about making this human figure. He is actually depicting a character from a movie franchise, which is John Wick, and he's the same main character from the movie. So for this particular project, I have just worked with polymer clay. I've taken a skin color polymer clay and trying to condition it. And after conditioning, it looks like this. It took me a lot of time, few hours to achieve this conditioning and then work on the face. Once I've made a base face, what I'm trying to do is fill up the dents or the, you know, imperfections here and make it all smooth. As I was saying, conditioning takes a lot of time for it to reach to, you know, the point where you can sculpt with the polymer clay. Sometimes it takes minutes, sometimes it takes an hour as well, or more than that. So finally we get a smoothened face part, and now I'm working on the neck as well. At this point you can just see whether the neck proportions are in line with the face part. Move to the nose as well. I have actually made a very tiny triangular shape and then trying to smoothen it out into the face part. I'm also trying to make the eye sockets with the help of a ball tool here. For the tools and everything I'm using in this video, I'll be attaching all the links in the description box, so you can check them out, and if you still have any doubts, you can always ask me. Whenever you are attaching a separate part to an existing part, like in this case we are trying to attach the nose, always the smoothening and blending part is needed, which takes a lot of time, effort and patience. Once you are happy with working on nose, you can always go for the ears. And I have made two balls here which are of equal size. And then you can see I have just attached it to the side of the face and then working on the blending and smoothening part for the ears then. I'm making the shapes here and also the holes in the ear. I have used a dotting tool and then few sculpting tools for smoothening it again. You must have noticed a rough sheet of paper lying aside. I always try to make a rough sketch of what I'm making, and that really helps me to keep the size in proportions, and in between and all I can just go and check whether I'm following the size here, or it really helps me. So I would request you to do the same if you are trying sculpting at all, or especially in case of human figurines. As you are seeing that I have worked on two hands here, and only that part will be seen, so kept it aside. Next up, we are going to work on the chest part for John Wick, and I have taken white polymer clay, which is quite brittle at this time. I worked a lot on it for conditioning and then it became like this. And the chest part was made. And as you can see, I am working on the collar part now. And I already made a collar, but I was not happy with the thickness. So I'm going to attach one more layer on top of it. And I obviously wanted to film it as well. So that's how it is. Meanwhile, I'm working on the neck and blending that as well. Before attaching the different parts of the body, I'm going to put wires, as you can see in here, and then attach it together. That gives a lot of strength to our sculpture, so I would totally recommend this at each and every point. So the bottom ones would be going into the pants part, and later I actually removed them and had put a very much longer wire because these were not reaching till the bottom. I'm taking some black polymer clay and conditioning it, making it very soft. Here I'm I'm just working on pants, making it of the right size and proportion, and then going to attach it to the chest part. Those of you who are new to my channel, I am Akanksha. I am an artist based out of Bangalore, India, and this is my art page. My online art studio name is White Musk Crafts. I am there with the same name on Facebook and Instagram, so you can totally connect with me. Or if you wish to order something handmade from me, you can always connect with me. And I also take workshops almost every month, so if you wish to do that with me, please drop me a message. As I was saying, you can check out a lot of my artworks on my Facebook and Instagram pages and support them if you like my work. Once I reached this point, I actually baked everything together and then waited for it to cool down. Once it did cool down, I actually worked on all rest of the details we'll be working on, and also the face part. By the way, if you want to try out your hands on sculpting, I would not recommend you to try human figure for the first time, because they are a bit on expertise level here, okay? And always try with basics and practice and then move towards the ladder, right? That's the perfect way to go about it. If you noticed, actually my sweaters in this video have changed. Maybe I had made this project for about 2 weeks, and that's how I completed it. So whenever you see a video online, it's not like that it's done in a day or a few hours. It takes a lot of time to try out and then finally present you what I do in front of camera. But this time I've tried my best to shoot my maximum while working on a project, and show it to you guys, because I get so many requests from you that why don't you make a human figurine from scratch. So that's what I'm trying to do here, and hope it helps you. You can see how much detailing has gone into making a belt portion. And as you can see, I have only made the front part, because the side parts won't be seen. The guy would be wearing a full blazer, and that's why the sides are not needed this time. For the topmost layer of blazer, I have rolled out a big piece of black clay here, and then trying to cut it and shape it as per the rest of the figurine. This is a 3D human figure, so it's much more difficult than making a 2D figure, which is placed on a base or a canvas. Lastly, I'm working on shoes and going to attach that as well, texture them a bit, and then bake the whole thing again. So this particular project was done, of course, for a huge John Wick fan. And by the end of the video, you'll notice that how I've placed it on a card holder, where a person can actually put his office cards and use as a office decor in his office. Once I worked on the blazer part here and all the details, I worked on the face part separately. As you can see, I was not very happy with the hands part, so I actually gave it a better shape by sanding them and then attaching it to the figurine. John Wick also has a pet, a pit bull dog, so I created that as well, a very mini version of that, and I actually loved it. So this is the final outcome. I really hope you like the video. Please let me know in comment section. I'll be waiting for them, and please subscribe to my channel. See you until next time. Bye bye, and thank you so much for watching.